We decided we wanted to do something unique when it came to the emblems on this vehicle. So the Hauk tailgate and the Hauk emblems on either side of the hood are going to have waterproof LCD screens mounted behind them. That way when you turn the vehicle on, the emblems come alive. All right, so here's the tailgate off of our renewable fuel build. We're gonna go ahead and get rid of the tire carrier mount. We're gonna completely smooth it out with a brand new panel that we drew in AutoCAD. We went ahead and checked it all out. Everything looks good. We're gonna go ahead and send it off to the Alpha Laser and get it cut.
So now that we have this beautifully cut top sheet, we have to prep the surface of the tailgate so we can permanently mount it. To do that, of course, we have to remove all the paint. This raised section in the center has to come out so that the top sheet can sit flush with the rest of the sheet metal. And we have to cut reliefs so the LCD screens can shine through.
We're gonna be stripping out a lot of things in this Wrangler that we don't need. First thing we're gonna do is pull out the dash and find a way to put all of our new odometer gauges in the factory dash setting. So here's a couple panels out of our JL project. We have our factory gauge cluster that's gonna be getting some new odometer gauges. We have our control panel that was in the center console. We're gonna remove all of those controls. We don't need them anymore. We're gonna put an aluminum panel in there with some new switches for our new intended purpose. In keeping with our race-inspired theme on this flex fuel build, we decided we wanted to run a 32-gallon Jazz fuel cell in the back of our JL, mounted and held in place with an R-Tech fuel mount system. We went ahead and had Dave design and draw up a new mounting system that attaches to the factory bolt points in the back of our JL cargo area.
This is the gas tank bracket I just finished fabricating up to mount the Jazz fuel cell in the E85 build. We just got to TIG it up, powder coat it, and install.
So now that we got all of the crusty, nasty, burnt parts off of our JL Wrangler, we can go ahead and put all the new replacement parts in place. We contacted our friends at Gladstone Jeep, and they sent us a whole batch of factory replacement parts. All right, so this is our replacement front fender on our JL project. It's got this nice little side indentation for a fake vent from the factory. We're gonna utilize that for our side exhaust. We're gonna make it look like this indentation was here for our exhaust to be coming off the Hellephant. So we're gonna go ahead and trim this up, trim the area behind it, notch the firewall, and have our exhaust coming right through the fender. Are you tired of all the hipsters and their big giant gauges in their ear? I know I am. Let's fight back with real gauges from Autometer.